In his remarks at the event that marks the end of the year and the end of the term of the Leader of Opposition and Leadership of Accountability Committees, Mpoga noted that it will be a political blunder for the opposition to participate in the 2026 general elections with the current electoral laws and constitution, saying that the 1995 constitution was invalidated after the dropping of presidential term limits.
It will be suicidal for the opposition to plan to go for the next election without meaningful constitutional and electoral reforms. I personally contend that we no longer have a valid constitution. The 1995 constitution and what it portends today are two different things.
Mpoga urged all opposition political parties to jointly find space and time and consider whether the opposition will be part of the next election or whether the opposition seeks to go in the next elections with the same legal regime and electoral laws and constitution.
I believe the opposition needs to quicken whatever is inhibiting us from talking about constitutional and electoral reforms. I know so many of us in the opposition have misgivings in elections. But if you believe that the elections are part of the framework to highlight and bring to bear enough pressure on the regime to climb down their high horse and undertake reforms, then invariably we must be the ones leading the pressure.
The Leader of Opposition also spoke out on allegations that opposition legislators participated in squandering money that was meant to compensate cooperatives that lost property in wars. He noted that those implicated in the embezzlement of the 164 billion shillings cooperatives' money should be sorted out by the law.
Matters involving corruption and partaking of what is not due to you is a matter of personal probity. But political organizations where people come from have an obligation to align their members, to remind them of their duty to nation and their parties.
Mpoga also blamed the recent public uproar about giving out postcards to former speakers, especially those still holding public office, on the lack of clarity in the law on who is deserving of these public packs, and urged the Attorney General to issue a legal interpretation on which individuals are entitled to getting retirement packages.
The issue I have, and I think this matter must be debated in the Commission and also have an opinion of the Attorney General of the Republic, namely, at what stage must one take a benefit over these packs? I think it's a question of interpreting the law. Can somebody take a benefit when they still have the extra benefit, when they still have a lien on the public pass? That's a question that the legal minds must break down.
The Nyendo Mukungwe legislator also questioned the motive behind the discussions on who will be the next Leader of Opposition amid the numerous accountability challenges the country is grappling with.
Changing the law is an undertaking by the party, and when the party does so, it must be respected. And that cannot represent a crisis in the country or in the party. A political action taken by an institution must be to a consequence. It must be for a particular, objective. And that objective should be left to the National Executive Committee of NUP, to which I am a member.
The outgoing chairperson of accountability committees, led by Joel Senyonyi of COSASE, also delivered their accountability.
When we inquired into Uganda Railways Corporation, produced a report, 48 billion shillings that was absquatulated with a locomotives deal, a fake locomotives deal. We recommended that these people be fired and be prosecuted. The MD and the board were fired, but we have been waiting for prosecution. So they only implemented part of our recommendations, because that's a lot of
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.